Hey guys, happy Monday. Per Mondays, we squat, all right? And so just like the previous Monday, we want to do some back squats, transition into our front squats based on the percentages. Again, each week, just try to build a little bit over a little bit. If you guys can hit the percentages exactly, albeit, go for it. However, most importantly is that we track progress and then that we build week in and week out. The back squat, again, the barbell will be on your back, rest right on top of the shoulder blades below the neck. In no way it should be on your vertebra, right? If you squeeze your shoulder blades together, it kind of creates a shelf, and the barbell should rest comfortably against that, all right? We want to pull down on the barbell, even though that sounds counterintuitive. We want to create tension throughout the whole body, so then that way we can recruit as many muscles as possible in order to stabilize the weight so we can move it most effectively, all right? Once we get done with that, we'll transition to our front squats. The front squats now, it'll sit across the throat, right next to it, just kind of comfortably uncomfortable. I like to prescribe it, and our elbows or our triceps want to be parallel to the ground. That means our elbows are facing forward, and so those are the two things that we worry about as far as the bar positioning. Again, what's normal with squats is the feet stays flat on the floor, no heels, no toes, it's just the complete foot connected, and then we want to keep the knees pressing out, and then we want to try to recruit the back of the body as much as possible, meaning our hamstrings and our glutes, all right? And so I'll shut up, and I'll show you guys the back squat, and then I'll show you guys the front squat. So those the back squat and our front squat. So guys, have fun with this one. And once we get done with the strength component, we're gonna go into our conditioning component. Now on Mondays, we like to use the rower, and so that will not change. However, we're gonna recover on the row, and then we're gonna break up the row efforts with a different movement. We're gonna break up the row effort with a dumbbell snatch. Now with this dumbbell snatch, it's one dumbbell. You guys want to alternate. I think the number's 8, so just 4 on one arm, 4 on the other arm. It's a lot of different ways to do this. Essentially, the dumbbell moves from the ground to over your head with no stopping in the middle, right? And so in terms, your body kind of move very similar to a kettlebell swing. If you guys want to re-bend underneath it, that's completely fine. I'll show you guys different things with the hands, and we'll just kind of go through it. Some people just want to like rip, almost like you're starting a lawnmower, and that's completely fine. And so you will go wide here, drop your butt, show me the chest, and then you'll just palms facing the body. You'll just rip it up, and come down. That's completely fine. I like the variation where my palms are facing in. I just love the way the support feels over my head. And so the way I tend to do this is I'll keep the barbell close, same principles, right? And then I'll just, from here, I'll just rip it up. And then I'll just kind of use my legs to kind of get underneath it. So for me, I'm that guy. And then if you're this guy or gal, it's completely fine. But that'll be your dumbbell snatch. So you guys are row, snatch, row, and then you guys recover on the rower. So that'll be your format, and then that'll be your Monday. Happy Monday. Go get it.